Hello, world. Mr. Resistor here. Continuing our alpha journey. And let's see. So, last time, we lost our fire tail. And I realized that I forgot to change my home station. Okay. So that way, I can just self-destruct, save myself the long flight home. Alright, can I use this yet? No. 16 minutes. Okay. What's our situation? No battlefields going right now. I believe Arzad is the big push right now. Although, what was the... Tararan seemed like that was where stuff was going on. But Arzad is the push, because that's where the Stark men are from. But in the meantime, what do I want to do today? I've got some skill points. Cool. I only need one kill. I think let's see. Alright, let's see if anyone has any good fleet issue probe fits. Thank you. they're saying rockets 0.44 per second. So is that slightly over 2 seconds rate of fire? 26 kilometers with rockets. That's intense. Okay. Rapid light missiles. Alright, so maybe we'll spend a little bit of time playing around with some fittings. So went with missiles on this one. Particularly impressive DPS. So let's take a look at our bonuses here. Bonus to light missile and rocket rate of fire. Okay. Scan probe launcher. So this dude just has shield extenders. Like four shield extenders. And the whatever the low slot shield recharge thingies. Two Nosferatus and two rocket launchers in the top, and looks like all shield mods, but I can't tell which ones. Ah, okay, here we go. 1 medium shield extender plus 3 small shield extenders. Faction or abyssal. 3 shield power relays in the low slots. 2 shield purgers in the rigs. And then a bunch of implants. So that's gonna be 10,000 EHP, though. Forty-two. Looks like he tried it out twice. With some slightly different. Kaldari Navy. I mean, it's a real expensive fit. Like 200 million. Because it's like all faction stuff. But yeah, looking like he took on like 35,000, 42,000. Total damage taken. So that's pretty serious, especially for a passive tank. But yeah, 10,000 EHP. It's 6,870 shields, 228 per second. Like no resists. So I don't know about that. That doesn't seem great to me. But it is interesting, at least. Well, that's not useful. Let's look at Z Killboard. Markets. Nothing in highs. Medium, two medium FS9s. Is that afterburner? Control, ballistic control. Oh, he was running abyssals? Weird. Okay. know. What's going on here? Okay, so he's just going real hard on passive tank. Well, let's see what we can do here. We'll go ahead and leave that. Have my rocket skills yet. That's why we need the wonder. No. Stick control to rigs. What do we have in here? We can definitely don't need that. Yeah, that'll be fine. All right, so we need some power. Do I want to spend 38 million on the ship, though? What are these selling for? 13, so it's still like 25 mil in parts. Well, let's get a couple of those.
Warp drive active. Docking permission requested. Docking request accepted.
Take these back with us. All right.
Warp drive active. Docking permission requested. Docking request accepted.
So, yeah, so I was watching a fitting guide the other day from, I'm blanking on the name of the guy, but learned a few things. So one of those being that, like, in addition to overfitting extenders, you can also overfit boosters. So wondering if that might be a viable option. Actually, if we went with two of those, that actually reduces my cost, but then I gotta get T2 version of this. So that's viable and actually cheaper, which is funny. T2 rocket launchers would probably be cheaper too. But not much I can do about that. That's actually pretty good. My signature radius is 62. Other thing he was saying for the ancillary boosters is that you actually want to use the smallest cap charges you can, because apparently, like, it doesn't really matter how big the cap charge is, and you just get however much per cap charge, and so the smaller the charge you use, the more you can hold, so you use whatever it is, the 20 or 25 Navy ones. So let's see. I guess it'd be 75. Charges per cycle is 1. 164 per 3 seconds for 6 cycles. Ditch that though. Get another extender. Now, like maybe passive shield is the way to go. DPS. Still looking at 20 million for parts, which I don't particularly like, but those are the expensive ones. That's actually most of our cost right there. If we drop those down to T1, that would reduce the cost significantly, but I don't know. I don't know if it's worth it. All right, well, here we go. So let's see. it's actually pretty efficient. So we'll just take never mind. Take all of them. All right. Well, we're at 40 minutes, so let's just... Oh, that's not what I wanted. Try this out real quick.
Drive active. Drive active.
So this is not going to be a significant test of my tank, but should at least give me a feel for the ship. What's my range on this? So. Okay, that's not too bad. Well, no complaints so far. We'll just have to see. Hopefully tomorrow,
Warp drive
how it
active.
does in the faction. Oh, excuse me. Yeah, so we'll just have to see tomorrow, how it does in the action warfare sites.
A module has run out of charges.
Too bad.
Warp drive active. Warp drive active. Docking permission requested. Docking request accepted.
Right. Activate that.
Skill training completed.
Well, it'll take us a minute. Oh man. All right. Allergies are killing me. But yeah, it'll take me a minute to finish up that rocket training. So, But I guess that's something to look forward to. All right, well, anyway, that's going to be it for me for today. So until next time, have a good one.